Hi, I'm going to demonstrate how to write user programmable feature for UserCreep function. Let's take a small problem for a demonstration purpose so that the same concept can be extended for any practical structures. The problem is that there's a unit cube of material which is stretched by a certain amount for 0.1% axial strain, and it is held for 1000 hours. This material follows a creep law as given here. The incremental creep strain is power of the equivalent stress as given here. So this is the creep law we need to be used to predict the creep strain and stress relaxation in this material. The material properties are given here. The Young's modulus is 210 to the power 3 megapascal typical steel, and the initial strain is 0.001. This is given in percentage, and the K and N are the material constant, and they are given as 5.0 × 10⁻²⁷ per hour, sorry, it's per hour, and N is 7. One can calculate what is the initial stress as Young's modulus into strain. That will give us initial stress. First, let's see analytically how to calculate the creep strain and stress relaxation curve. It is going to look something like this. With respect to time, the creep strain is going to increase. The creep strain is shown in the primary vertical axis, and the stress, initial stress is 200 MPa. It is going to relax over the time. The stress values are shown in the secondary vertical axis. Okay, so we can see how we can analytically calculate. So at initial time, there is no creep strain, and analytical creep strain is zero, but the stress in the material is 200 MPa. Now let's split this 10,000 hour into small time increments. So every time 10 hour increment. Now we can calculate what is the incremental creep strain. This is nothing but the K times stress, that is a 200 is the initial stress, power N, that's nothing but the 7. This is the incremental creep strain for this particular stress value. This has happened over 10 hours of time. Okay, so this is the actual creep strain that has occurred into the structure. So because of this creep strain, there will be some relaxation on the initial stress value. That is nothing but the original stress minus the strain multiplied by the Young's modulus. This is the relaxation stress, and this is the original stress. This is what is going to happen. So when we go to the next time point, here the stress level is not the original stress level, but the relaxed stress level, and it's stress power N multiplied by the K value. Okay, and again, this is the incremental creep strain. So the total creep strain is the strain in the previous step plus the relaxed strain. That is nothing but the incremental creep strain and the time increment. This is nothing but the 10 hours. This is the total or equivalent creep strain at 20 hours. There will be again relaxation in the stress. This is nothing but the initial stress minus the relaxed stress. The relaxed stress is nothing but strain multiplied by the Young's modulus. So we can calculate like this for up to 1000 hours. So at 1000 hours, this is the stress strain, creep strain at the previous time, plus the incremental strain that has happened. The incremental strain is calculated from the stress at the previous time point. Okay. So now this is for a simple structure. for a complex structure, the stress at different nodes are going to be different, so it becomes very complicated to do it manually. So we are going to use Ansys to do the calculation on a realistic structure. Now let's see how can we model this. The first step is to look at the existing creep laws that are available in Ansys. So open Ansys help manual, search for creep. So if you go creep here, so here are the creep laws, different creep laws that these are available in Ansys. Probably we can use the strain hardening law. This is the equation that Ansys uses by default. If you look at the equation that we need to use, we could use probably the strain hardening law. The C1 is nothing but K and C2 is nothing but 1. We can make C3 as 0 and C4 as 0 so that we should able to solve this problem using the strain hardening material model that's available in Ansys. But however, for demonstration purpose, I'm going to write a new user creep model that consists of only C1 and C2 and demonstrate the procedure, okay, for you. So to start using UPF, the first thing is that I'm going to use Workbench Mechanical Environment. You may go to App Store. Here is the App Store website and search for UPF. So I'm going to use Ansys version 18.0 for this demonstration. So when you look at the UPF app, this app is meant for 17 series and this app is meant for 18.0. So make sure you download the app which is compatible with the version of Ansys that you are going to use. Okay, you may download this. It's going to be a zip file. I've already downloaded this here. So this is the downloaded one. Extract this one. So there is a doc folder which UPF, and go through this document carefully. This shows how to use this app inside Workbench Mechanical and so on. Okay, so carefully go through this document before you start using this particular app. And another important feature is that to use UPF, you should have Visual Studio and Intel Fortran compiler. And every version of Ansys requires a compatible version of Visual Studio and Intel Fortran compiler. For a particular version of Ansys that you are using, you can go here and check the compiler requirement. For this particular version, that is version 18.0 of Ansys, we need Visual Studio 2002 and Fortran compiler 15.0. Okay, this is mandatory that we use exactly same version of Visual Studio and Intel Fortran compiler as mentioned in the help manual. I have Visual Studio 2002 installed on my machine, and also I have Fortran 15.0 installed on my machine. So make sure your Visual Studio and Fortran installation are correct before you start doing UPF related stuff. So once this is verified, the next job is that I need to copy the extension itself that's available in bin folder. Copy this file and go to %opdata:, and go to this folder version 18.0 act extensions, and you can paste your op here. I already have this, so this is UPF. Once you have this installed, then you can come to Workbench and extension and choose this UPF whatever. So you will get, when you are doing it first time, you will just get the message that the extension UPS was successfully installed. Okay, second one is the manage extension, and make sure your UPF is on, and you can create a new project like static structural here. So for this particular work, what I'm going to do is that I'm going to bring up a model which is just one single element for a verification purpose. Extension, manage extension, make sure the UPF is on. Just to open this, so when you open this, a toolbar called user programmable feature will appear here. This model is nothing but I have just a unit cube model. The dimensions are 1 unit by 1 unit by 1 unit here, and I have meshed it with one single element. Okay, so every edge is given with one element, and this is constrained in such that when I apply a unit force, there will be a uniaxial stress state in this particular material. Okay, so that's the model setup. I have done nothing related to the UPF. The first thing is to make sure your Visual Studio and Fortran installation are correct. Check this UPF. If you have right Fortran compiler installed, it will say you have proper version of Intel Fortran compiler. Then it will check for the Visual Studio and finally say you are good to go and use user programmable features. Okay, so the basic installation check is done here. The next thing is writing the UPF itself. So for that purpose, go to my computer, your Ansys installation directory, Ansys Inc. I'm using version 18.0, common files, then MPI, Windows HPC. This UserCreep is a sample file that is available in the installation itself. Copy this file to some other working directory. In this case, this is my working directory. I'm just going to copy paste this here. Okay, copy this file here, edit with some notepad editor. This is the example file given in the Ansys installation itself. This example file exactly implements the strain creep law that's given here. That is the strain hardening law. If you look at this, you can see here the C1 is nothing but K, equivalent stress, power N is nothing but the C2, then the creep strain times C3, here M is nothing but the C3, then the exponential of C4 by T, the C4 is nothing but minus BT is the temperature here. Okay, this is the creep law that's implemented here, which requires 4 as an input property. But in our case, what we need is that only this portion, not these two portions. So I'm going to delete this. Anyway, this is just the comment. It's not going to influence anything on the result. But the actual equation itself is coded here. Okay, it's going to get 4 input properties, but in this case I need only 2. I can delete these 2, and also it is going to check some other thing. This is C4 by constant and so on. This is the exact creep law that is being implemented. I'm not getting into the mathematics of this, how this equation itself got converted into this form. I leave that to you to doing the math. But the equation that I want to modify is like this. I don't need these two terms. I'm just going to modify this so that it's going to be exactly the law that we are looking for. And it has the output that we are going to pass it back to Ansys solver is this one, the derivative of incremental creep strain with respect to the effective stress, and the derivative of the incremental creep strain with respect to effective creep strain. So in this case, the derivative is going to be 0. So I'm just going to make this as 0. Well, I think we are set to go ahead with this. I have implemented the creep law, which is suitable for my problem description. So save this file. Now let's start doing this. So when you insert use UPF, you asked browse particular location UserCreep.f. This is the force, but in this case I don't need a unit force to be acting. I'm going to have two substeps in this problem. So in the first substep, what I'm going to just strain it. It's a fixed displacement condition. Okay, so displacement on this face, is 0.001. Okay, it's 0.001 is my initial strain, because this length is unit length. So whatever my strain is nothing but the displacement. The first load step is for a very small period of time to establish this initial stress. Okay, from then on, in the second load step we are going to solve up to 10,000. Actually this is hours, but we are going to kind of a cheat Ansys, because we are going to supply all the inputs in the appropriate unit system. Okay, so this 10,000, this unit we are really not going to use that, we are just going to use the number. So I want to solve for every 10 increments, so it's going to be of 100 substeps. So 100 maximum 1000, this is my thing. And the next part is to set the creep controls. By default, if I go under analysis settings, there won't be any creep related information available. Same way we can't see the creep strain. This is due to the fact that this this mesh or this model is not associated with any creep model. To activate any creep related GUI settings, we need to have some creep model associated with that. Go to engineering data, define a new material with dummy creep data. Okay, so any material model requires Young's modulus. This is a steel and Poisson's ratio is 0, and we need to provide some creep related thing. You can go and provide any creep related information, we are not going to use that. Use all 111. The another important thing you need to make sure is that whatever the solver unit system that you are going to follow should be same. Here I am using MM, so make sure you use MM to avoid any error related to this. Save this one and refresh the project. You come back here, you can see the steel with dummy creep available here. Now if you go to analysis settings, there will be a creep control. Okay, so in load step 1, turn the creep effects off, and in load step 2, turn the creep effects on. Okay, and also you can see the equivalent creep strain coming in, and also you can get equivalent 1 Mises stress and so on. And another important thing is that setting the environment variable for UPF compiler to work correctly. Okay, let's go back. Environment variable setting is explained in this document. If you go somewhere here, yeah, this is very important. The Ansys will look for Fortran subroutine from this particular environment variable. Okay, let's set this environment variable. The environment variable can be set here. Property search for environment variable. This is the Ansys user path is the environment variable. I supposed to use this particular path here. Let's go and check this particular path. Again, it's important that you set this path before you open a workbench module. Otherwise, this workbench session will not recognize that. Okay, you make sure you set it before you open workbench. In case if you forgot to do that, you need to save the project, close workbench session completely and open again. Okay, in this case I have set it so it should work as expected. Okay, make sure you close and open again. This is my okay, having set the environment variable referring to the correct UPF file, the next one is to provide, call the UPF and supply the appropriate material data. Okay, so there is no GUI option, we have to use the command option. I'm just going to explain here. So the first one, TB Delhi Creep material ID, is that it is going to delete whatever the dummy material data coming for the creep. Okay, it's going to delete this, and we are going to put new TB data. When we say this field is 100, it is going to use the user defined. We have two properties coming in, so that's nothing but K and N, that's been given here. We have completely defined the user defined creep material input, and also we have referenced where the Fortran routine is. I think with this we should go ahead. Let us try to solve this problem. Getting an error. Error solver module. Okay, it's in solver module. Let's look at the solver directory. Ansys tried to compile the thing. There seems to be some error. The error related to your Fortran file are available. Compile error underscore txt. Okay, end of statement missing. Let's go and look at this. Now what's happening is this is something that we have edited. I just want to make sure. The brackets are not closed properly. Okay, save the file. Having done this, come and reference that back. Now I think we should solve this. While it is solving, let's go back here. This is where we have done the hand calculation. This is what it is. Now let's try to get the I think it's solving. That first thing to check here is that as you are solving, somewhere it should say user link path. It means that UPF is working, it's going to link this file, and also you can go and look at the mechanical. There should be files related to compilation, and you should be able to see the compilation log and so on. Now we have solved the creep strain. First thing you need to look at is the initial stress. In the first solve, it should be close to 200. That's what we expect. Okay, we are almost close to that. And we got the creep strain. It's increasing from 0 to 2.2 e power minus 9. Let us look at it. This is going 2.2. Okay, it's same. And the stress is relaxing from 200 close to 150. Let's look at the stress from 200 to 150. What we can do is that we could really copy this the max stress value here and put it here and see how it looks. See, they are matching pretty well, and also the strain. Strain here, since the entire model is of same strain, the max and minimum is going to be same. That is the advantage of using a unit element for material characterization. Okay, and so it's in a uniform stress state, and you can put the strain. You can see I'll just zoom this for you so that see there is a very small difference because of the large time step size that we are using. Okay, there is a small difference because we are using the time increment of 10 hours. As we reduce the time increment to 0.1 hour or 0.2 hour, we can see these strain and stresses exactly matching with each other. Okay, and probably it's for a better housekeeping purpose. We can just go and rename and stuffs like that, and we can do that. Okay, I hope this demonstrate the typical procedure how one can write a new UPF and compile with the ANSYS and compute the results for your own.